Hello, my name is Henry Lukas. I'm the Education Director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History on the campus of Regis College in Weston, Massachusetts. And this is our monthly show in which we feature postage stamps that relate to historic events, birthdays of famous people, and other things going on in the news that we think you will find interesting. We do have a calendar that features a number of the stamps that we show during the month that connect the date with the stamp. And if you just email us, we'd be happy to send you a copy of that. Also, we hope we can get you to visit the museum. And if you do get over here, just mention that you've seen the show and we'll give you a nice big discount on the admission. I want to give out a quick, every month we'd like to give a shout out to a local museum. Just a little shout out to the Telephone Museum over in Waltham. I was over there a while ago meeting with Mr. Valentine, the director. It's a fantastic collection of telephones. And if you have a chance, get over there and check them out on their webpage. Okay, we usually like to start the show with our trivia questions. We had two trivia questions last month. One asked for a connection between the stamp honoring the California Pacific International Exposition and the Shakespeare stamp. And the other one asked, what was the last ceremony for a first day issue to take place at the White House? And we had a one answer. Mr. Robert Salvi, one of our regular viewers, sent in the correction for both answers for both the correct. So we thank him for sending that. This month's trivia question is going to be a little difficult. We'll see. You see two stamps behind me, one of Dag Hammarskjöld, the former Secretary General of the United Nations, and Nassau Hall, which is the oldest building on the campus of Princeton University. And I wonder if you could make a connection between the hall and also Dag Hammarskjöld. And the second trivia question, you see a picture of many people consider the father of jazz, and that's Jelly Roll Morton. And if you take a look at that stamp, that photograph was based on another photograph, but something is missing from the stamp that was in the photograph, but not on the stamp. So if you can tell us either of those answers, send us an email. You can see the email address right on the bottom of the screen. Although this is August, last month we failed to mention two important events. One was the Tour de France that started in around the early July. And there is a postal connection with the Tour de France. You can see some stamps that have been issued to celebrate it. But it turns out a few years ago, the United States Post Office sponsored a team and it included the infamous, I guess, Lance Armstrong. And just recently in the news, the Post Office sued Lance Armstrong because of the dope-taking incident. And according to the latest newspaper, they'll be receiving about $5 million as reparation for that kind of situation with Armstrong and the doping situation. And of course, we also failed to mention the World Cup, one of the biggest sporting events in the world, probably watched by more people than any other event. And I just want to show you behind me some stamps that have been issued in the past celebrating the World Cup. So this is August. And many people call this the Dog Days of August. Why do they call them the Dog Days? Because it's based going way back to the ancient Romans, that during August, very hot day, and they associated with Sirius, the dog star, which showed up, coming up with sunrise, bringing the heat with it. It was the brightest star in the constellation Canis Major, and so hence the name Dog Days. But speaking of dogs, as you can see behind me, dogs are a popular subject on postage stamps, both in the United States and around the world. And actually, we have a very famous dog connected with postal history, and that is a dog named Oney. Oney was up in Albany, New York, back in 1888, kind of a straggly dog. He hopped on a train that was carrying the mail, and before you knew it, he was riding trains all over the country, and then eventually even got himself on a mail ship and went around the world. Probably the most famous postal dog, and he was with the post office from 1888 to 1897, and then when he passed away, the National Postal Museum down in Washington, D.C., got a hold of a taxidermist, and they preserved him. So you can see a picture of him, and you kind of notice he has a lot of tags on him, Those were tags that were put on by the different post offices that he visited. So another famous dog who has appeared recently on... let me get back to two other dogs that are featured on Australian stamps. These are 11 dogs, mostly Springer Spaniels and Labrador Retrievers, which were sent out to an island off the coast of Australia, Macquarie Island. And there were a lot of rabbits and other pests there that were killing all the penguins. So they brought these dogs out, and over a matter of months, they were able to get rid of all the pests and preserve the island. So Australia issued these stamps to celebrate the work that these dogs did. But that other dog I was going to mention to you, probably the most famous dog in the cartoon world, and that is Scooby-Doo. And if you head out to the post office, you can get your Scooby-Doo stamp. It's a forever stamp. It was issued on July 14th. They had a big ceremony at the Mall of America in Bloomington, Minnesota. So if you like Scooby-Doo, make sure to get your Scooby-Doo stamp. Since it's August, we all like our ice cream, so we always like to feature those postage stamps that have ice cream on them, and you can see some ones from England, and of course Nancy and Sluggo, the old Sunday comic strip there. So we hope that entices you to have some ice cream. In fact, ice cream cones were actually invented at the St. Louis Fair, and you can see the picture that features that on there. If you haven't been able to get away in August and you want to have one of those staycations, we recommend visiting all our national parks. Back in 1934, Roosevelt, one of our most popular stamp collecting presidents, urged the Secretary of the Interior, Harold Ickes, to advertise the national park system. So they came up with stamps from 1 cent to 10 cent featuring all the parks, Yosemite, Mount Rainier, the Grand Canyon, Acadia up in Maine, Mesa Verde, Yellowstone, Zion, Crater Lake, Glacier, and the Great Smoky Mountains. And you can see that series behind me, one of the most popular sets of stamps that were issued. And secondly, just the last month in July, we featured 16 stamps, all related to America the Beautiful, including an image from Bailey Island nearby up in Maine. Those stamps you can get, and you can see that collection behind me. So we always feature a little treasures of the vault, and those are special things that we put out for exhibit every now and then. Have a little more value than a lot of other stamps. And this month I wanted to show you. This month we feature what was called catapult mail. And before they were able to fly planes across the Atlantic to deliver mail, they would put a plane on the back of a passenger ship, started out with the Ile-de-France, and when they were about 450 miles from shore, they would shoot the plane off and it would land and get the mail there much earlier than waiting for the ship to dock. And these envelopes, here's one, this one actually didn't make it. They sent it out from Staten Island to land on a ship, and it was so foggy the pilot couldn't find the ship, so he went back. But the envelope featuring a 10-cent stamp, and these are quite valuable to collectors. And the other one here was one that was on the Ile-de-France and has French stamps on it. And again, so catapult mail was an interesting way before they were able to finally send mail directly across the Atlantic Ocean. We always in our show feature our presidents, and August and September we have our various birthdays. Let me just get those birthdays out for you. And then some of our current presidents, who obviously are not on stamps yet because they're still alive, both President Obama and Mr. Bill Clinton have birthdays in August. It's also LBJ's birthday. Herbert Hoover had a celebration out in Iowa where he was born. And Benjamin Harrison, also born in the month of August. And we only had one president to die in August, and that was Warren G. Harding. Died on August 2nd, 1923, and Calvin Coolidge became his became president. Well, it's that time of the show again when we invite our stamp collecting alligator, Archie, to come up and show us something from his collection. Archie, you down there? Hey, Arch. Oh, what do you got, Arch? Arch has an egg. I understand, Archie, you've been raising chickens and you want to send the eggs to your customers, and you have something that was used way back in the 1920s. Can you bring that up, Arch? What do you got? Ooh, here we go. There we go. All right, Archie. Sorry there. It's light. It's light. This is a way eggs used to be mailed back in the 1920s or so when parcel post was introduced. Farmer's wife usually would go down to the chicken coop, pick up the eggs, put them in one of these containers, and then close it up, put some stamps on it, and take it down to the train station, and then it would get delivered maybe one or two towns over. They'd put some more stamps on it, send it back, and it would go back and forth. Very lightweight aluminum, which was something new at the time. Well, Art, that's a great thing in your collection. I understand you have even a bigger one. That was two dozen, but you got one here. I need to help you a little bit. Oh, here we go. All right. This is Archie's, whoops, all right, didn't mean to, you okay? Okay. This is six dozen eggs. And actually we have seen pictures of egg crates up to 15 dozen. So you got, now the other thing Archie has, but he couldn't bring it today, people also used to send laundry through the mail, usually college students. And Archie has one of these, you'll see a picture behind me. Put in your old dirty laundry, send it home to mom, she'd clean it all up, send it back to you at college. So these are interesting things for your collection. All right, thanks, Arch. We'll see you next month. Can you get that? There you go. Oh, okay. We also like to, since we have viewers in India, we like to feature a stamp from India that celebrates a famous Indian citizen. And I get my notes out here, a little disorganized, I apologize. It's this month we're featuring Biju Patnaik. He was a daring pilot and a patriot of India. He was inspired in the boyhood by meeting Mohandas Gandhi, and he helped in the independence movement for India. And as you can see behind me, he's featured on a stamp. He died back in 1997 at the age of 81, but well known among those who worked for independence from England. And one thing we've failed to mention in our previous shows here in the year 2018, and that is our good friend Mickey Mouse. 2018 is the 90th anniversary of the first time Mickey Mouse had appeared in the cartoon that Walt Disney did. He's become rather famous on postage stamps, and recently Italy introduced a stamp. But we also found out that the first country that featured Mickey Mouse was back in the early 70s, shortly after Walt Disney passed away, and that was the tiny country in Italy called San Marino. But as you can see beside me, since then, many countries have featured Mickey and his pals from the Walt Disney Studios. So the latest one also, France also introduced a Mickey Mouse stamp. So keep your eyes open for more Mickey Mouse celebrations during this month. Okay, and then the other thing we want to mention, and that is the Norman Rockwell. Recently we saw an article in the paper that people who posed for Norman Rockwell got together to talk about their experiences when they were young being painted, and that reminded me that Norman Rockwell did a very famous Boy Scout stamp, and I believe the person's name was Percival Thornton, and I don't know whether he attended that reunion or not, but the interesting thing about it, even though he's on a Boy Scout stamp, he wasn't a Boy Scout. But Norman Rockwell was asked to design several stamps for the post office, including the city delivery and a Tom Sawyer stamp. So Rockwell, not only a famous painter, but his artwork has appeared on a number of stamps. So that's pretty much our information about stamps for the month of August. We hope you have a chance to come by the museum. We have our various exhibits. We have an exhibit featuring the Alvin submarine, research submarine. We have some envelopes that were carried on that submarine. And we also celebrating the 49th anniversary of landing on the moon with an exhibit of space stamps for that. So please come by and see us, and we'll see you next month as well.